Based on data published by Utah's Division of Water Resources, agriculture in Utah consumes 4.2 million acre-feet of water per year. 1 acre-foot of water is simply 1 acre of land submerged in 12 inches of water. You could submerge the entire state of Hawaii with 4.2 million acre-feet of water. In terms of gallons, this staggering amount of water is the equivalent of 1,368,000,000,000 gallons of water. The USDA reports that 87% of cropland is used to irrigate pasture land and to grow alfalfa and hay. This does not include such crops as cattle feed corn that is used in feedlots. Utah's irrigation water used to grow alfalfa, pasture land, and hay totals 3.6 million acre-feet of water. That is the equivalent of 1,185,000,000,000 gallons of water. To get an idea of just how much water Utah uses for cattle feed, imagine Utah cattle feed farmers filling up 1 gallon jugs of water and placing them in a straight line. The line of gallon jugs would stretch the entire length of the country, 2,848 miles, not once or twice, but 39,145 times. This highway of water bottles crisscrossing the country would be 6 miles wide. With a flow rate of 2.8 million acre-feet, the Colorado River supports a population of 40 million people. The amount of water Utah uses to grow cattle feed is 23% more than the total amount of water flowing down the Colorado. Cattle feed crops are literally sucking Utah dry. Ryan Larson, a Utah State University economist, reports that 27% of Utah's alfalfa is exported to Asia. Alfalfa exports consume 320 billion gallons of water. In comparison, the Bear River's flow rate is 723 cubic feet per second, amounting to 170 billion gallons of water. Bear River is the main water source for the Great Salt Lake. The amount of water Utah uses on alfalfa exports is more than enough to save the Great Salt Lake. Are alfalfa exports more important than the health of 2 million people? Utah's not facing a water crisis, it's facing a water management crisis. Funds from the Federal American Rescue Plan Act provided Utah with $250 million to help solve its water crisis. Utah used the money to install what they term as secondary water meters. Calling these water meters secondary water meters is deceptive. The appropriate term for these meters should be the Great Salt Lake Water Diversion Meters. Billions of gallons of diverted canal water are being used to irrigate homes in the counties surrounding the Great Salt Lake. Most of the canal companies that divert water away from the Great Salt Lake charge one low flat fee for residential water, irregardless of the amount of water consumed. If you water once a week or if you water 10 times a day, residents pay a flat fee. If you water 10 acres or a fraction of an acre, you also pay the same flat fee. These so-called secondary water meters are being installed in hope that consumers will voluntarily begin to conserve water once they realize how much water they are using. Half of the water the Davis and Weber Canal Company diverts away from the Great Salt Lake, comprising a total of 45 billion gallons, is used to water residential lawns. Even with the new meters, consumers are free to water the lawns multiple times a day at a flat fee. The health of 2 million people are threatened by toxic dust storms, and yet water is being managed as an inexhaustible resource. The U.S. Geological Survey reports that Utah residents are using more water than any other western state. And, according to the Utah Rivers Council, they paid less for water than any other western state. Driving through the neighborhoods in St. George and in Salt Lake City, one sees home after home with green lawns. Many of Utah's subdivision homeowner associations requires its residents to have green lawns. Despite the governor stating that the drought to be a state of emergency, the state legislature couldn't even agree to pass two proposed bills that would allow residents to conserve water in green grass homeowner associations. House Bill 121 failed to pass, and House Bill 95 is still pending. Instead of conserving water, Utah is contemplating building a $2 billion pipeline from Lake Powell. Like all western reservoirs, Lake Powell is far below capacity. According to the Washington County Conservancy District, the average household in St. George uses 159 gallons of water a day. In contrast, the U.S. EPA reports that the average American household uses 82 gallons per day. In one of the driest locations in the United States, residents of St. George are using nearly double the national average to keep desert lawns green. If Utah continues down this path, residents of Utah will have green lawns and brown lungs. To discover both short- and long-term solutions for saving the Great Salt Lake, watch part 4 of this series.